guys. It is Joy Ani scrapping in my own private Idaho, and today we are working on 31 Days of Treats. And this is another pencil holder, and I will show you a few things that I did. And super easy to make. And remember, you can make them with or without a Cricut, and I'll talk about that as I go along. You can make this project in less than 5 minutes. So for my box people, we have in your little bag for day number 19, you will have a black base, a pumpkin, the topper, so you will have a base, a pumpkin, the topper that goes on top, the circle, the 2-inch circle that you will set your pumpkin on, and this is what we roll to make fit our pencil. And we also have this little green thing, and this is the tongue. All right, so I will put this together super quickly. So I'm just using a tape runner really quick, and I think I'm gonna put the green down here first. Yes, not upside down. I'm using my mess mat because I have such fun time getting all this stuff on here. So there's my green stem. My little pumpkin. In the box, you might have small black things. To be quite honest, anytime they have tiny things, I am just going to take a pin because I am not all about doing the little tiny things. Now, my friend Nettie, she does this kind of stuff all the time, and she does the little small things. So I'm going to put some glue. I hope I'm going to put some glue, a dab of glue. I got this green glue. It never seems to. Okay, I always have a pin handy. And I'm just going to make a little puddle because sometimes it is so hard to get this on here. So I did find the little tiny googly eyes. I'm just going to set it on there. I think the Cricut Cut might have a little tiny, but like I said, I am not all about putting little teeny tiny pieces, especially if they're really a file that has a lot on it. Tweezers work great with this. I'm going to put this little yellow tongue right here. I'm going to put up some more glue on here, and then I'm just going to put it right here. There's his tongue, because isn't that the color of a pumpkin's tongue? Would be yellow. Yeah, isn't he gorgeous? Oh yes, I'm so punny. I do write my own materials, but I would say I'm not going to quit my daytime job, but I retired, so I kind of did. So here, that goes on here. Now, remember, with our pencil, we have this 1.5 by 1 inch by 1.5, and we are going to roll this. Roll them, roll them, roll them. Okay, but you don't want to get it so tight you can't get your pencil in there. So I am going to, now that I've got the green glue going, I'm going to put it right like this. And I'm going to wrap it around. So remember, we talked about, if you do not have a Cricut, you can still make these cute little things, probably with what you have in your house. So I'm going to flatten this a little bit and put it on the back, and I'm putting it right under the stem because that's where I want the pumpkin to go. And the reason we flatten it a little bit does make it harder to get the pencil in, but it adheres better. And I remember we talked about how you're going to leave it. If you're going to glue it, you want to give it a little bit of time to adhere. So I'm going to, so this is the Cricut one. If you pop over to my Facebook group, Joy Ani Scrapping in My Own Private Idaho, I will have more samples of things that I've done with pencil toppers since I bought so many. So I bought them from Amazon. Oh, that did not stay on there. I may have to do glue dots on this one if it's not going to stay. And to be quite honest, I'm probably not going to take it off. So there's my. And then this is what makes it cute up at the top. So I'm going to put glue right I'm gonna point this so that you can actually see. I'm gonna put it right up at the top. I'm trying not to get it on the eraser, but just knowing that I might kind of. So we just can't make errors, I guess. And then I'm just gonna put that on the top, and that will keep it from sliding around. So I'll show you what else I've made. So remember, I buy one stamp set a year, and this is the one. It's called Potions and Spells, and this one I colored in. It's the crow from Potions and Spells, and I'm just gonna put that on there, and I'll make a pencil topper out of him. This one, I stamped it on the light side of the black cardstock, and I put a googly eye, just so that you can know, and I'll have these finished projects also pictured on my Facebook page. And remember, you can use, to make your own, you can make, this is a 2-inch, I'll go ahead and finish this one up. This is a 2-inch circle square that I had in my stash. I'm going to, oh, I didn't bring a pencil out. Well, we'll just pretend, right? I'm going to roll it around and put it on the back. This is a 1 1/2 inch. And then I used a 1/2 inch punch that I showed you yesterday. So remember that you can use, the goal really is for you to use what you have in your stash. And these are inexpensive things that you can give out. Like I said, I went on Amazon because I couldn't find any Halloween pencils, because I started this project in August, and now I have 200 pencils, and it's just really cheap, and then you don't have to worry about food allergies, and pencil toppers are fun. So I hope you have a great day, and please like and subscribe to my page. I will see you tomorrow, and we will be doing another fun project.